Hi, in this tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to make this bracelet right here. This bracelet is not my own original design. Actually, it is just the very popular inverted fishtail bracelet. And I'm going to be showing you how to make it on a finger loom. Now, if you do have something else, like just a regular loom, or two pencils, or two forks, just look up another tutorial because there are just tons of those out there, but this tutorial is specifically for finger looms. But yeah, so I'm going to go ahead and tell you what you're going to need. So, to make the inverted fishtail, you're going to need two pins. Any two pins will work, but this tutorial is specifically for finger looms. So, if you want to make this bracelet with just any two pins, just find another tutorial. There are tons of them out there. This tutorial is specifically for finger looms. You will also need a clip. I'm just going to be using this C-clip because I just have a ton of them just sitting around. You can use any clip. And you will also need rubber bands. I'm going to be using two colors. I'm going to be using turquoise and neon green, both from Rainbow Loom and both opaque rubber bands. There will be a link to the Rainbow Loom web store in the description where you can also get a finger loom from. So, I cannot really tell you how many rubber bands you will need because this is a growing bracelet, which means as you make it, it progressively gets longer and longer. And yeah, so however many rubber bands you will need is determined by how big your wrist is. But you will need a few more rubber bands that you do need to make yourself a regular fishtail. So some people say you need about 5 more rubber bands than what you need to make yourself a regular fishtail, but I have no idea because I've never made myself one of these. So yeah. So anyway, now that you know what you're going to need, get your supplies and use the pause button so that you can do so, and I will see you once you have everything. Alright, so to get started, you're going to get your first rubber band, and this first rubber band we're going to be placing is going to be your cap band. Now what you're going to do with this cap band is you're going to place it on one of the pins and stretch it horizontally across your finger loom and twist it while you do this. So you're going to stretch it out to the other pin on the other side, but when you do this you're going to twist it onto the other pin so you get this 8 shape here, or this cross or X in the middle of your loom. Then you're going to get your next color, and you're going to place it going across these same two pins, but you're not going to twist this rubber band, and you're not going to be twisting any more rubber bands. You only need to twist this first one you placed. Then you're going to get your next color, or your next rubber band, I guess, I should say, and you're going to place it going across the same two pins, and what we're going to do is we're going to just loom the bottom rubber band over on both pins, like a regular fishtail. So over here on the left, grab the bottom, pull it over. Here on the right, grab the bottom, pull it over. Now we're going to get our next rubber band, place it horizontally across our loom. And we're going to do the same thing again. We're going to just grab the bottom rubber band, pull it over the pin. Same on the other side, grab the bottom rubber band, pull it over the pin. Alright, so now our pattern is going to start. So we're going to actually start making the bracelet the way it should be made so you can make the inverted fishtail. So you're going to get your next rubber band. You're going to place it going across the same two pins horizontally. And what you're going to do is a little different this time. What you're going to do is you're going to grab this middle rubber band. So on one of the pins, you're going to grab the middle rubber band, and you're going to pull it underneath of the bottom rubber band. So like this. You'll release it, and now the old bottom rubber band should be now in the middle. And what you're going to do is you're just going to pull it over the pin. Very simple. You'll do the same thing on the other side. You'll grab the middle rubber band, so the current middle rubber band, put underneath of the bottom rubber band. Grab the new middle rubber band and pull it over the pin. So that is the inverted fishtail pattern that you will follow. And I'm going to go ahead and show you how to continue this pattern 3 more times, and then I'm going to leave you to finish off your bracelet on your own. So, to make the inverted fishtail, you're going to place your next rubber band. So you should have 3 layers of rubber bands on both pins. And to do the inverted fishtail stitch, as most people call it, on one pin you grab the middle rubber band, pull it underneath of the bottom rubber band, release it, and now you're going to grab the new middle rubber band, so there should be a new rubber band here in the middle, pull it over the pin, and release. You'll do the same thing here on the other side. You'll grab the current middle rubber band, pull it underneath of the bottom rubber band, and release. Grab the new middle rubber band, and pull it over the pin. Alright, so I'm going to show you 2 more times. You're going to grab your next rubber band, place it going across the pin, same 2 pins you've been using. Now you have 3 layers of rubber bands on both pins. Once that is true for you, you're going to grab the middle rubber band, the current middle rubber band, pull it underneath of the bottom, grab the new middle rubber band, pull it over the pin. Same on the other side. Grab the current middle rubber band, pull it underneath of the bottom rubber band, grab the new middle rubber band, and pull it over the pin. Alright, and now I'm going to show you one more time. So, you have 2 layers of rubber bands. You get your next rubber band, stretch it across these same 2 pins you've been using. It should be horizontally on your loom. What you're going to do is, once you have 3 layers of rubber bands on both pins, on one of the pins you're going to grab the middle rubber band, pull it underneath of the bottom rubber band, grab the new middle rubber band, pull it over the pin. You'll do the same on the other side. Grab the current middle rubber band, pull it underneath of the bottom rubber band, grab the new middle rubber band, and loom it over. Alright, so now I have shown you how to make the inverted fishtail bracelet 4 times, I'm pretty sure 4 times, and well, that should be enough times for you to understand how you make the bracelet here on your finger loom. And yeah, so I'm actually going to cut the video here. I'm not going to fast forward myself continuing this bracelet, because it will probably take me a while, and you're going to continue making your bracelet as well, but you're going to be using the pause button. And yeah, so you're just going to continue this simple pattern of placing and looming over and over until you make your bracelet long enough to fit around your wrist. So once you've done that, you're going to continue the video, and I'm going to show you how to take your inverted fishtail off of your loom. So I'm going to go ahead and cut the video. Just use the pause button if you need to. Alright, so as you can see, oh goodness, as you can see here, I have now made my inverted fishtail bracelet long enough, so now it will fit around my wrist, and you should have made your inverted fishtail bracelet as long as you need to make it, and once you have, it is now time to take it off of your loom. So to do that, you're going to need your clip, and well, that's pretty much it. So, to take this bracelet off of your loom, you need to make sure you only have 2 layers of rubber bands left. So if you have 3 layers, go ahead and do the regular inverted fishtail stitch, and then you can continue. So anyway, once you have 2 layers remaining, what we're going to do is we're just going to loom the bottom layer. So here on the left, we just grab the bottom rubber band and pull it over the pin, and just really release. We do the same on the other side. Grab the bottom rubber band, pull it over the pin, and release. Very simple. Then we should only have 1 layer of rubber band for one band, remaining on these two pins. So what we do now is we're going to bring all of the rubber band together. So to do that, you're going to grab one side of this rubber band, pull it off of the pin very carefully, and bring it over to the other side, where the other end is. And now only one pin on your loom should have rubber bands on it. Now you will get your clip, and you will attach it to this rubber band here. So just attach it like that. Now once your rubber band is, your rubber band has your clip on it, you can take the clip and the rubber band off of the loom. And now your clip should be attached to one end of your bracelet. Now you're going to attach your clip to the other end of your bracelet or your cap band, which should look like this little circle here. What you gotta do here is you just need to stretch your cap band onto one pin, because the finger loom pins are pretty big. And all you gotta do, get your clip on the other end of your bracelet and attach it to the cap band on the other pin, or on your pin. So cap band here on the pin, let's get your clip. Attach it, easy. And then you can take your cap band off of the pin once your clip is on it, and now your clip should be attached to both ends of your bracelet. So once that is true for you, you can go ahead and put your bracelet on. And bam! So as you can see here, I am now wearing my inverted fishtail bracelet, and you should be as well, hopefully. I'm gonna go ahead and take this off. So I guess now it's time for the outro. So I would like to thank you for watching my tutorial. Hopefully it showed you how to make the inverted fishtail bracelet successfully. And hopefully you are enjoying your inverted fishtail bracelet. And yeah, that's pretty much all I have to say, other than thanks for watching, and bye!